Trust me, I understand that. And they send you and those knuckleheads to threaten me. To obey and serve once more. I understand that too. But what I don't understand is... You bastards killing me!
Just any monkey. He's a monkey of merit. A monkey was made Buddha once. None other than me can challenge him to a duel. Look, monkey. I don't make a habit of fighting someone I've bested before. Here's my offer. If you lose, I'll take you to the Celestial Court. They will stay and level your mountain. But if I lose, I shall certainly take revenge, and they will level your mountain nonetheless. How tragic would that be, huh? You are one of the court. We don't need to resort to violence. How about you bend the knees, admit the wrongs, and we can put this behind us?
All these years, except for that pig, you're the one who talks the tallest tales. Good, I am entertained. Speaking of entertainment, wouldn't it be fun if I pluck your extra eye out for my snack and allow you to keep the other two? Because I'd hate to let you miss how I'll slaughter each mongrel of the court. Those below, those above, and that black mutt of yours. Come at me, all of you.
They gave you many charges. Each one, such ingratitude.
For that word, all realms and beings have ruined themselves.
Welcomed you, foul monkey, yet you remain untamed. None shall save you now.
Dear brother, your edge needs honing. Good. I was in need of a back scratcher.
Okay.
You call that a duel? The glare up here is dazzling. Fight me in the woods if you have the guts. And so ends the last tale of Sun Wukong. A hero who treasured his freedom above all else. Buddhahood he attained, yes, but cumbersome he found the celestial rules, for he yearned to come back and to revel in the simple joys with us. Little did he know, his choice to forgo the life above only fueled their mistrust. This stone has stood for countless days on the mountain. Since my youth, they've said that his remains lie within it. Unbegotten, undying, such is the nature of a stone monkey. Though his body was broken, his spirit endures. Into six relics he turned, and separately they escaped, choosing to stay hidden. Those are the six senses of the great sage. Yet no one has ever seen them, not in centuries. I'm old now. Venture through all the lands, I cannot. Yet among you, there might be one who is destined. One that shall recover all his scattered relics. And upon the return of the relics to Mount Tuago, he may yet rise again.
age, death, and ever grow.
Huh?
Here, you see what bliss my fate
shows. Luck's around the corner. Seems like you just fell from a fruit tree here.
Perfect timing. This peach knew I needed a snack. You sneaky rascal! Dad, fool me! I'll make sure you regret it!
No matter how many times you come around, you're still as mischievous as ever, eh?
Have long been waiting for your arrival.
Our mighty king's got cereal.
It's been a while, but the immobilized spell still works like a charm. Since you hail from Mount Huaguo, it won't hurt to teach you a handy trick. Now, here we go. Give me your hand. There you go. Should you come across any miscreants, just point your finger at them and release this spell. You'll be able to hold them in place while giving yourself a breather. Sadly, mine is but a humble trick. Its power will wear off within a few short moments. Though it's good enough against boneheads like this one. Anyway, just consider it an ace up your sleeve. No! The young ones these days know no manners! Fear not. Teach them a lesson with your new spell!
Ha ha!
swap so much. Thank you.